Hello, brothers and sisters in Christ. You're welcome to today's broadcast as we continue on our study of the Word of God, as recorded to us by St. John's. And the Word of God today, it's one that we need for our everyday reassurance of our hope that is in Christ Jesus. And today we shall be reading still from chapter 10, and I will commence reading at verse 22. John chapter 10, verse 22. And I read, At that time, the feast of the dedication took place in Jerusalem. It was winter, and Jesus was walking in the temple in the Canabe of Solomon. So the Jews gathered around him and said to him, "How long will you keep us in suspense? If you are the Christ, tell us plainly." Jesus answered, "I told you, and you do not believe me, and you do not believe. The work that I do in my Father's name bears witness about me, but you do not believe because you are not among my sheep. My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. I give them eternal life, and they will never perish, and no one will snatch them out of my hand. My Father, who has given them to me, is greater than all, and no one is able to snatch them out of my Father's hand. I and the Father are one." This is the word of the Lord. Beloved, this is the last verse, which is verse 30, says, I and the Father are one. And this demands our attention, especially in a time like this, that people, we still have people that doubt the divinity of Jesus. There are still persons who question why the Christian believe that Jesus and God are the same. For some, they argue, and they argue vehemently, but they argue from the perspective of their own scriptures. But we argue from the perspective of our scripture. And not just our scripture, from the mouth of Jesus himself. And it is not accidental that this question was asked Jesus. We are told that Jesus had gone to the feast of dedication in Jerusalem. And the Pharisees, while Jesus was walking in the temple, the Jews gathered around him. And they said to him, "How long will you keep us in suspense? If you are the Christ, tell us plainly." This was a direct question. They were not mincing words. This was a direct question. And the direct question that they asked Jesus pertains his identity. They wanted to know the identity of Jesus Christ. For them, the identity of Jesus Christ will solve all problems. And I believe it is also appropriate for our time. Jesus' identity has never been hidden from the whole world. Jesus' identity has always been there, as the Word of God claims. Sometimes you will hear men will tell you that Jesus never said that he is one with the Father, or that he is God. But this is one classic example. In John chapter 10, verse 30, he says, "I and the Father are one." And that is profound. You can choose to accept, and unfortunately, many have chosen to reject that assertion. But it is not our assertion. It is the testimony of Jesus about himself. It is the identity of Jesus about himself, the testimony of his identity about himself. And Jesus went ahead and said to them, when they asked him that question, he said to them, he said, I told you and you do not believe me. So the biggest problem is not whether Jesus is the Son of God or whether he is the same with the Father. That is not where the problem is. The problem is, are you willing to accept it? Are you listening and watching this episode? Are you willing to accept it? Are you willing to accept that Jesus and the Father are one? And that is the problem. And Jesus rightfully says in verse 25 of John chapter 10, he said, I have told you and you do not believe. So the problem is not whether Jesus has said so, because even when Jesus says it a million times, as he has said severally in scripture, people will still say, can you tell us? Can you further simplify? But Jesus said, I have told you and you do not believe. He now said to them, even the works that I do in my Father's name bears witness about me. So Jesus is saying, listen, even the work, even the things that I do bears witness. The work that I do, the healing that I do, it bears witness to who I am. It bears witness to my identity. It bears witness to my person. It bears witness to the things that I have come to offer. And Jesus says in verse 28, he says, I give them eternal life and they will never perish. This is audacious. Jesus not only claims to be the Christ, as they asked him, he says he gives to his disciples, his sheep, those who follow him, he gives them eternal life. How much clearer can those words be? How much direct can Jesus be? He just told them that the ones, the sheep, hears his voice and they know him and they follow him. So those who are not followers of Jesus, they are following him because of disbelief. And don't join in that category. Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Savior. Jesus is Deliverer. Jesus is our Redeemer. Jesus is our Shepherd. And Jesus and the Father are one. Jesus and the Father have come that you will have life and have it abundantly. Listen to what he says. He said, I give them eternal life and they will never perish. In Jesus, we have eternal life, unperishable life, and no one will snatch them out of my hands. My Father, who has given them to me, is greater than all, and no one is able to snatch them out of the Father's hands. You can be rest assured that you are in safety in Christ. You are in safety in the Lord Jesus Christ. No one will ever snatch you out of God's hands, out of Jesus' hands. Do you know the reason why? Jesus and God the Father are one. That is what the Word of God tells us. The Word of God says it. I believe it. The Word of God says it. His disciples believe it. The Word of God says it. His sheep believe it. The Word of God says it. Those who believe him, trust him. And listen to me, because the Word of God says it, we believe it. That settles it. Thank you for listening to today's broadcast. We'll continue on this study on our next edition.